It's an extraordinary protest, sending a message loud and clear. Today, media organisations across the country have blanked out their front pages in a united stand against government secrecy, so journalists can bring you the truth.
The PM in Indonesia, Sam Burgess, slapped with an AVO. Wallabies coach quits. But today's headlines were lost in a front-page protest by media companies fighting on a united front to be able to tell the news of the day.
When the government hides the truth from us, what are they covering up?
Nobody here is saying that anyone should be above the law. The question is, does the law serve the public interest? Right.
That law triggered a raid by federal police in June on the home of News Corp journalist Annika Smethurst.
I was pretty surprised. I didn't expect them to show up at my door.
They left 6 hours later. Her alleged crime, reporting a story with the help of a whistleblower about new government powers to spy on us all.
I think that's the biggest risk. It's that people who see wrongdoing will no longer speak up.
The newly appointed Federal Police Commissioner, Rhys Kershaw, walked into an ambush at a Senate hearing this morning.
Have you seen the front page of the Sydney Morning Herald?
I have now.
The Financial Review?
Does the AFP plan to have any other further raids into any other media outlets or other journalists' homes?
Not that I know of.
His officers were acting on the orders of the government.
Does the Prime Minister agree that journalism is not a crime?
I agree that journalism is not a crime. There is no one in this country, Mr. Speaker, who is above the law.
The media is pushing for 6 reforms, including the right to contest search warrants, protection for whistleblowers, and restrictions on secrecy. But the so-called right to know crusade has been lost on the former Deputy Prime Minister.
You can't say putting a private individual, a pregnant woman crossing the street on your front page, is in the public interest.
Today's media blackout is unprecedented. A game changer. Well, an ongoing parliamentary inquiry is expected to have the final say. Damien Ryan, Nine News.